My new book, The Buried Giant, is set long, long ago in Britain. It's actually set in the 5th century. So it's a long, long ago, and it's after the Romans have left Britain. So the empire has withdrawn. But it's before the people that you would know of as the English have actually arrived. The Anglo-Saxons are arriving as immigrants and settling in the country. So we're talking about a very mysterious period in the history of Britain when it has not become English and it has just stopped being part of the Roman Empire. And there is a very uneasy atmosphere between the ethnic groups that live within the country. Okay, so that is the period in which it's set, but it's not really a very accurate historical setting because there are also ogres and pixies, all the things that people of that time might have believed in a superstitious way, I have allowed to actually exist in a literal way in this book. So it's a metaphorical, mythological version of this mysterious bridge point in Britain's history. So in this setting, we have a love story, but it's not a love story about two people who meet for the first time. It's about a couple who have been married for a long, long time. And a mysterious thing is happening in this world of my book. People are suffering from memory loss, nothing to do with old age and dementia. Everybody, young and old, children, everyone is suffering from some peculiar kind of memory loss. Some strange mist has settled on this old Britain, which causes everyone to lose their memories in a very strange way. And so this old couple are troubled that their precious shared memories of their life together, all the years that they have spent together, has disappeared. And they know that there are some very important things missing, and they fear that perhaps their love for each other will die if they don't have their precious shared memories. So they set off on a journey across this troubled Britain to try and find these lost memories. What they don't realize at the beginning of the story is that if this forgetfulness that has settled all across the country, if that disappears and everybody remembers, it will bring back bad memories as well as good memories. And it will bring back perhaps memory of conflict and civil war. And it might actually set off violence and hatred all the way across this land. They don't realize that yet. And so the book is very much about this question. When is it better to remember? When is it better to forget? And keep memories, bad memories, buried. I should say about this story, some people might think they need to know a lot about the old literature and texts about King Arthur and all these things from ancient kind of British literature and French literature, of course. But I have to tell you, this isn't necessary because I'm quite ignorant about all of that. This isn't a book that involves allusions and intertextuality and very clever things like this. This world that I have built came out of old samurai stories, old Japanese myths that I grew up on when I was a small boy. Things like the Odyssey, things like that, the old Greek myths, and actually you might be surprised to learn that old Hollywood Western movies, cowboy movies, had quite a big impact on this. Of course, there are knights and warriors, but they're quite similar to aging gunfighters in some of the great westerns of John Ford or Sam Peckinpah. People who are out of their era, whose time has passed, and they're lone figures in this bleak landscape under a big sky, just a man and a horse. So all of these things, Kurosawa movies have gone into it, but it's, you don't have to be some sort of specialist scholar in old European literature to appreciate this book. The story is completely self-sufficient. Well, for the past year already, now the Buried Giant has been optioned to be turned into a movie by the legendary Hollywood producer Scott Rudin. And so there are all kinds of discussions about how to turn it into a movie. And I'm afraid I can't give you any information about that right now. And of course, it may be successful, it may not be, but we'll see. But I've had two previous books, The Remains of the Day and Never Let Me Go, both turned into quite big movies, very, very good movies. And so just at this stage, when there's discussion about adapting my new novel into a movie, my feelings are quite interesting at the moment. Now, you might imagine I'll be quite protective about my book, but partly because of my experience in the past of having books adapted, you might be surprised that my fear is that filmmakers are too loyal to the original book. Because I think I've seen too often films that are not very good films because the filmmakers have not allowed themselves to express themselves artistically. They think of themselves more as translators rather than artistic creators in their own right. So film and novel, they're such different forms. And I think I always try and encourage filmmakers to be quite bold and to depart from the book when it's necessary. The important thing is that there is a very good film and that the film has to survive on its own. And I part of the reason I believe this is also because I think this alliance that exists at the moment, a very strong and powerful alliance that exists at the moment between cinema and the novel, it's a very important one in our culture. Not long ago, people were predicting that books, or novels anyway, would disappear altogether. We'd all be playing video games and doing other things. But actually, this hasn't happened. All across the world, the novel remains very, very central to culture. And this is something to do with a very strong alliance with the cinema industry. Almost every week, there is a new big movie that the might of the Hollywood machine gets behind, and it is based on a book, a new book or a classic book. And this is very good for books. People, that power goes back into the book industry, and people become excited about books. Cinema, on the other hand, I think absolutely needs the ideas from the books. Otherwise, you know, cinema today would just descend into trash and sequels. And it's a lot of the energy is coming from books. So the film that is adapted from the book is very important both for our reading culture and our cinema culture. And as a team, as an alliance, it's enabled storytelling to remain absolutely at the heart of our culture.